Okay, so in this video, it's going to be covering matching transactions. Now, as I told you before, we use the rule set. I come up here to edit, apply rule set, and basically just shows us what rule set was used. It was a simple rule set, just matching amount and posting date. I purposely did not match up the posting dates because I wanted to have something to show you. So here we have these two. The posting date on the bank is the 27th. Posting date in Intacct is the 26th. The bank date's the wrong date. I did it just so I can do that. So what you want to do is, to get them to match, you select match, and then it'll show you on the bank side, you select match, and it shows you this information here, what you want to match it to. You can click the one that matches it and click match. Now, this is very simplified. I know there are many times when you have multiple items in Intacct that can match to your bank and vice versa. But this is just to get you started. We have that matched. Our remaining to match is at 0. So we can go match or match and go to next. Let's match and go to next. 5600. There it is. Amazing. Wouldn't it be nice if everything matched up like that all the time? And then we could click match. Okay, so now our bank is clear. There is no unmatched transactions here. We can come here to matched, apply filters, and we can see what we have here that's all matched by this here. We can come to Intacct, unmatched. There are no unmatched. And come here to matched. And apply filters, and we see all these here. We click on match, brings us to this information here. As I told you, until you hit the reconcile button, nothing's reconciled. So you can unmatch, and it'll change your uncleared by the amount that you unmatched. So go back to unmatched, apply. We can come here and click this. And you'll see it shows what you have selected was a debit of $6,649. We don't have any credits currently. We could. I could switch this over to matched, apply filters. That's fine. Me, where is it here? Here's my debit. Here's one of them. I click on this deposit. I unmatch it. I'll go back to my unmatched. Apply my filters again. In the bank, let's go to unmatched, apply my filters. You can see that they're unmatched once again. I can come to Intacct. I can select these to match. I'm now looking at 69 and 15,000 selected to match. Now, the thing here is, if I select match now, and I come over here, these still aren't matched. So they're shown as unmatched. So we'd have to match them. Let's see what happens when we do this. Oh, wait, we don't have any transactions. Oh, no, what are we going to do? Well, we're going to cancel. We're going to go back to Intacct. We're going to do our matched. Apply filters. And then we're going to come up here. We're going to check this. And we're going to check this one. We're going to unmatch them. We'll come back over here to unmatched, apply filter so we can see them, go to the bank, and let's match them this time. So we'll come up here, we need to match the 6600, click it here. If you click here, it's going to give you an issue there. It's going to throw your remaining match all over the place off, and it won't be available to match with the other transaction, so don't do that. Let's do match and go to next, click. Match, go to next, and there is nothing left to match. I just want to show you that in case I know somebody was thinking, he didn't hit the go to next, so maybe there's something left. There's not. We'll come here to go to match, apply filters. Come here, go to match. Well, you know what, let's just do all. Apply filters. You can tell the state by it says matched here. It can match, it takes you back to that other screen that you can unmatch or whatever you want to do. Now, I'm sure you're thinking, wait a minute, our amount to reconcile is 849. I thought you said it had to be at zero. That's correct, it does. Again, you know, I planned this. So, now here you have, oh no, what are we going to do? We have $849 not matched. Where is it at? Well, in that case, you're going to have to come in here and create an entry, most likely, to either pay a bill, make a deposit, receive money, create a journal entry, things of that nature. In this case, we're going to go to edit, and I'm going to go to change my statement ending balance to 9151. But I made a mistake on my ending balance and continue. And now it's at zero. I can save this here and come back to it later. Whoops. But it plays funny like that. So let's come here. Then I see we still haven't reconciled, so it's still giving us initial open items, but it has updated to last used. Continue. And you saw that it showed it was in a state of draft. It's in draft because we haven't clicked the reconcile button. But we're at 0, 0, everything matches, all is right with the world. So we could reconcile, but I'm going to hold off on doing that because I want to save it for another video. So that ends that there. I do want to show you this, though. Since I have done that reconciliation, view reconciliation history, I mean, since I've saved it, it's not reconciled, so it's not going to show anything here. But if I go to my checking list, you can see pending reconciliation. I click that, it gives me three options, CSV, Excel, or PDF. I can pull a report in PDF and it shows me the reconciliation report, the pending reconciliation report. So that's really neat, especially when you need to get items verified. You know what I think I'll do? In order to have fun at a later date, we will come back to this. I'm going to change this back to 10,000 and continue. That way we have something to play with. So I can show you how we're going to fix this here at a later date when we get into AP, okay? Sounds good. Sounds good to me too.